Guess who have come together? Who do you think it is, everybody? It's Amy!
Surprise!
Yeah. What it is I'm just putting up... Oh, there's a message. But I'm just... The headlines of the day, which you can look at. But the one thing that's overshadowing everything is... Well, I just wanted to say tyranny! I've said it now. Tyranny!
Yeah, that's right.
Basically, we're going to talk a little bit about the... election.
Yeah.
What a load of rubbish. What a waste of time, waste of taxpayers' money, the whole lot.
Oh, yes, it is.
Well, when we were talking to Nigel last night, who is the Devil's Playground, the Hangout, that's the Hangout name, that's the channel. He was saying that in some of these states, more votes have come in than the people that live there, so they're going to have to be recounted. What's your take on it, Amy?
Oh, yeah, I think that's terrible. I don't know, it's some kind of fraud or whatever, but I think they're just dragging this whole thing out and making it very dramatic.
How much more dramatic can you get when Biden only needs 6 more votes and he's won? I mean, on that bit, but some of his counts are going to be recounted, so, you know, it might find that Trump wins them and then it changes the whole thing.
Yes, it reminds me of the Bush Gore election back in, I guess that was 2000, and it all came down to Florida, and they kept fighting over Florida, and then and even the lady that was just certifying the votes, they had to recount. She said she was satisfied that Bush had won. And she certified it, and Gore just wouldn't let it go. And then finally the Supreme Court said, enough is enough. This is not the American way. We're not deciding an election in the court system. And, you know, they conceded that Bush could win. And but that's what this reminds me of. But they just want to stretch it out as a decision, in my opinion. It should never take this long or be this crazy to just count these votes. It should be simple. And a lot of it, I guess they could blame they had a lot of mail-in votes maybe and things like that. But
what difference? Do you know something? I think it's a waste of vote is a mailing vote or one of the votes like where they have to count them, because... Just say there wasn't all this happening and Biden got 6 more votes, he'd be in. So what does all the votes that people sent in or did by, you know, they needed to be on the day they were counting them, like when they've given out their totals, because what's yours a wasted vote otherwise?
Right. I've never seen anything like it except for the Gore-Bush election. The night of the election, be able to call it that night. It didn't take that long, and I thought Bush won. And back at that time, I was a Republican Bush supporter. I was so excited, and then they said no, he didn't win. There was all kind of contention with Florida, and so they had to go back and redo it. And it took us a few weeks. And that's really not how we want it to be in the American system. We should have our president the night of the election. And all this early voting they have now, that's another thing. Like 10
days. I mean, in one reality, those votes are in first. Those ones should be counted first.
Yes, I think they are counted first, is those ones. But I don't understand either why we have to have all this early voting, because back in my day, we had one day you went to the polls, you had from 8 o'clock or whenever they opened in the morning till they closed at 8 o'clock at night. By midnight or so, you knew who was the president. So just this whole system is really messed up at this point. The whole system is messed up. And
we've got a few more minutes, Amy. What else do you want to... Last night, well, I think he got let out and he's done another video, you know, from the march. I can't think of the channel right now. He got out and he was making videos on his way home, so that's good. But not very good what happened to everybody.
Yes, I know.
That was the march in London where people got, like, cattled in and stuff like that, but he's out now.
Oh, well, that's good.
And yeah, they mention of soldiers coming, which is martial law.
Yes, yes, that has me very upset. I couldn't even watch the announcement.
Oh, it says Downing Street refuses calls to lock for the lockdown to be broken.
Oh, yeah, it's got me very unsettled, all of it. Because I just feel like the whole world is coming under the tyranny, and I don't like it. And I'm very sad that America has not stood up against it. I see people are having protests about the election, especially Trump supporters that are protesting because they feel like the Democrats were crooked and did something. But they need to be protesting the lockdown is what they need to be protesting. But we're still under, it might not be as much as yours, but it's something we're under. Like my sister made appointment for the eye doctor December 1st, but whoever, somebody has to go with her because they'll put drops in her eyes. But we can't go in the waiting room with her. Gotta sit out in the car. It's insanity. There's no reason of why they can't bring the person in with them. It's absolute insanity. And I fear it'll get worse once the election is decided. So it's very, very, very upsetting. I feel very distressed about it, about the whole system and what they've done. And I'm very upset about the martial law in England. Because they're oppressing the nations all around the world, and it's just really...
One second, Amy. About a minute, Amy. I'll give you a minute.
Okay. Well, we're going to be getting free tests, my sister said. They're going to be delivering us some free tests we can all take, which I will not be taking. Right, because we know that they bring back false positives and their insistences when these tests. So I will not be taking them either. And remember, man in England that he didn't even take the test and he sent it back and it came back positive. And then he called the police to report what's going on and the police wouldn't get involved.
It must be the solution, isn't it? It's their solution that's got the COVID in it.
Yes, it's something like that. Yeah.
Amy, anything else then? Because we're coming to the end now.
I just hope that this would all come to an end, but I don't see how it will. But I'm just very disconcerted.
Can't even identify it, and they're doing all this.
Exactly. But we have to stand up against it. That's when they get lying down. We got to stand up however we can against it.